Hello everyone, welcome to the session on parallel databases. Now in this session we will see what exactly parallel databases means, how it works, what is the architecture. Now talking about the learning outcomes of this session, at the end of this session you will be able to describe or illustrate the need of parallel database and what is the aim of its database. And you can illustrate the different parallel database architectures, how it is using, what kind of machine architecture it is using. Now, let us start with the basic goal of this database management system. What exactly database management system is doing? It is providing the way to store and retrieve the information. Any kind of information we can store or we can retrieve through this one. And the important part is it is using very convenient and efficient way for it. Talking about the management of data, what exactly means management of data? It means that it is defining some structure, fixed structure for the storage of a particular information. And it is providing various mechanisms for manipulating that information, like how you are selecting, how you are updating, modifying, deleting, reading, writing, or all these one we can say as a data manipulation things. And the database management system is providing a effective mechanism for this one. Now, let us start with an introduction that what exactly, why the importance of database is there and why we are going for this parallel database. Starting with the database thing, that we know that the databases are growing increasingly. Nowadays, everywhere, everything, whatever you are doing, that will be considered as an information and that is stored in some database. You can see now on any click of the internet, any message what you are sending or any mail you are sending, everything, even if you are going for e-commerce or if you are buying anything online, everything, whatever the transactions you are doing, that will be considered as a part of a data and that data is stored somewhere as a database. So it is increasingly, it is growing very high nowadays. Now, we know that, so based on that, the data what is generating, that is in a very high volume. And it is collected and stored for many of the analysis. Means everything, whatever you are doing online, that will be taken as a data and that is analyzed for the future development, for how the customers are interacting, what is the interest in the customer and many of that thing. So that is also one of the major reason where the database is growing increasingly. And we know that database is not exactly only data as a format. It is having images, videos, audio, video, everything will be considered as a data and that is effectively handling. So multimedia objects like images are also increased and stored in a database. You can see we people are using many social media sites for uploading our images, our pictures. We are doing that as our memory using that social media. So that is also one of the major use of the database where we are using. Now, what is the need of the parallelism in this case? We know that as the very large number of volume of data is there, many manipulations are there, the storage is there, retrieving is there. So it is required that we have to improve the speed of the execution, the speed of storing, retrieving, everything. So for that, we are taking the help of the parallel machines. What exactly parallel machines are? Parallel machines are quite common and nowadays even your for smartphone, your systems, your laptops, everything is increasing in the form of the parallelization. We are talking about earlier it has started as a single core, now it is multi-core. Your mobile phones are also having many cores in that one. So those are very common nowadays. And the prices of these, like microprocessors, memory, disk, whatever the peripheral devices we are using, electronic devices we are using, those are dropping sharply. So the recent desktop computers, they are having many multiple processors, many multi-cores, and this is accelerating day by day. Now, the basic goal of parallelism is what, as I told earlier also, that large-scale parallel database systems are increasingly used nowadays. So for many reasons, one of the thing is what, we are storing that for large volume of data. we are processing that volume of most of the volume of data for decision support system, where most of the decisions are taken by the organizations. So these decision support systems are having very time consuming. And the basic thing is why we are using this parallel databases. It is providing high throughput for the transaction processing, because as most of the transactions are there, many of the transactions are at a time working, means we have to get a proper throughput based on that. That is what the goal of the parallelism is. So this all thing totally where it is moving is it is moving towards the performance improvement. So most of the system, when large volume of data we are manipulating, many operations we are working on that one, it may get more time for it. So to reduce this time, to improve the performance of that one in the form of time, we are using the parallel systems. So that is what the goal of the parallelism is. So talking about the parallelism in databases, here what we are doing, the most of the data, the large volume of the data is we are accessing through the parallelism in that one. And how it is there, it is partitioned across the multiple disks and using the parallel IO, that is parallel input and output, where at a time we can read and write multiple disks. So automatically the work is parallelized here. So you can see the scenario here. I have taken a very small database example here, relation here, which is having some data in that one, but we are talking about in a large volume of data. So if the data is very high, large volume in this one, so that particular relation can be partitioned in many disks. So what we can do is at a time different processors can read these disks. So that is what we call it as a parallelism in database. So talking about the relational operations, like whatever the operations we are doing on that one, database manipulation operations like sorting is there, join is there, aggregations are there, these are requiring more time usually for the execution. So these can be utilized using the parallel techniques. So most of the parallel processors are there, the parallel disks are reading them. So it is working on a parallel thing. So consider this scenario here. Here what we are doing, a single query is there for sorting, but this sorting it is doing in parallel. So where the sorting of A to G, we are taking some example of sorting in ascending order. So according to these one, it is parallelly sorting the thing. So at a time, it is sorting like this and finally it is adding it. We'll see these one in detail later. Now data is partitioned in various disks, as I told earlier, and every processor is assigned to it. You can see here that this large volume of data is partitioned in different disks, and every disk is having its own processor. So what at a time three processors, that is processor P1, P2 and P3, are accessing simultaneously disk D1, D2 and D3. So automatically the work is distributed and the work is in parallel simultaneously. Every processor is working there, so speed is increasing here. Now queries are expressed in high level languages, and every SQL query is translated in relational algebra for the parallelized system. And different queries can be run in parallel with each other at a time. So the sorting might be there, joining is operation is there, selection is there, many of the things, whatever, those can be working in parallel system. And talking about the concurrency control is taken care of conflicts and all that one by the database management system. So databases are naturally lend themselves to parallelism automatically. Now the parallel database architecture, you can see this architecture here. What exactly is there? That most of the nodes are here, and these nodes are using these are shared. So this is what the database, parallel database architecture is. The disk might be shared, the memory shared, the processors are shared, whatever it is. So what we can see is machines are physically close to each other. You can see here the nodes are physically close and they are connected by the LANs and dedicated high speed LANs. So whatever the communication is going on in these one, that is by the intercommunication channel, this channel might be a high speed LAN. And the communication cost is, as it is using only high speed LAN, it is very small. And many of the architecture you can use here, that is shared memory is there, shared disk is there, or shared nothing architecture is there. Let us see all these one by one. Now in the shared memory architecture, you can see here how it is working. The memories are shared and this is the intercommunication network, and every processor, that is PE processor, these are the various processors, and every processor is associated with an individual disks. So what is shared here? Only the memory is shared. Doesn't matter that how many the number of memories and the number of processors are equal, there might be various number of memories also, and these are shared by these processors. But remember here, every processor is having its own disks. So what you can say, every processor has its own disk, and this it is using a single memory address space for all these processors, and reading or writing to the memory is more expensive here, because as memory is there and the intercommunication network it is using, so it is somewhat costly, we can say here. And every processor can have its own local memory also, even if it is not shown here. Every processor, like P, is having its own memory here. This one is also having, but these memories are shared here. Now, you can pause the video here and think of this architecture. Can you guess what exactly this parallel architecture is having? Like in this one, what is happening is, see what is shared here, and we can say that this is an intercommunication network and these are the processors and this is the memory. So if this is the case, then what exactly is shared in this one? You can see this one, like, yes, you can guess here that it is a shared disk architecture. Why? Because the disks are shared here and every processor is having its own memory. So let us talk more on this one. It is called as a shared disk architecture, where the disks are shared. This is the intercommunication channel where the communication is going on, and every processor is having its own memory. So memory is not shared here, only disk is shared. So every processor is having its own memory. All the machines are accessing only disks, and the number of disks here also is not necessary that those are equal in as the number of processors. It may vary. So what is the application? The Oracle system, Digital Equipment Corporation, is using this shared disk architecture. The next one is shared nothing architecture. What it is there, here nothing is shared, means every processor is having its own disk, its own memory. It is nothing is shared, but all these are working in parallel with its own things. And these are the most common architectures nowadays. Every machine has its own memory and disk, and many cheap machines, commodity hardware, communication is done through high-speed network and switches. So the application is this one. These are my references. Thank you.